Hey everyone, it's your professional sarcastic man and seeker of attention, Oz Chris, here with a new 52 flashback. I know the new 52 doesn't get a lot of, positive comments. I know the new 52 divided fans when DC decided, let's just do everything from the beginning again. Let's reboot everything. It worked for some stuff, it didn't work for a lot, and as such, when Rebirth came, DC was praised for going back to the kind of the roots, in a way, but just the main thing is like, we love Rebirth, let's forget that New 52 happened. But the thing is, not all of the New 52 was terrible. There actually were diamonds in the series, and a lot to I would use as good starts to just characters or series, whatever. And one of them definitely is this Batman, The Court of Owls by Scott Snyder. It's the story that introduced me to Batman, got me to read more of Snyder's work and more of just Batman in general. I do believe it is a good Batman story. It is, and without it, I probably wouldn't be reading a lot of Batman. You know, say what you will about how, I know Snyder does perpetuated the whole Bat God thing with Batman. It's just like, Batman has a solution for everything. Batman has this, this, and that to save the day. Why? Because he's Batman. You know, ignoring that, this is still actually, you know, a good, it is a good story, and you know, it's a nice simple kind of mystery uncovering a dark secret within Gotham City. Now, this would kind of work well as a detective comics, as it does. It does now and again occasionally show the detective side of Batman in this. It works very well. And one thing I'm going to point out is the art. Greg Capullo's art with Jonathan Glabion. And I know FCO did the inking and coloring. I do like the art in this. And it works very well with the story and the setting. Because to me, Any comic can have good art, but there's also art that works perfectly in sync of the setting, the atmosphere of the story. And Capullo's art alongside Glapion and FCO's inking and coloring works so well with the story. You know, you have Batman uncovering a supposed legend come true, a secret dark society, the Court of Owls, manipulating Gotham throughout the years, for almost untold amount of years, and Batman coming to terms with it. As early on in the story, he's one of the people that just says, the Court of Owls, it's a myth, it's just a legend used to scare kids. That's all it is. It's nothing. Then even adding to himself that after his parents died, he couldn't accept the fact that it was just a simple, Joe Chill went up and just killed his parents and that was it. But he wanted to say, oh, the Court of Owls is real. They decided to do it, but it turned out to be nothing. And from there, he kept on continually looking for answers for if such a society existed, and to no avail, he could not find anything until now. And he discovers that the court has been manipulating Gotham throughout the years, and also messing with the Waynes as well. And definitely 100%, it's a good mystery suspense Batman story from the new 52, 100%. Snyder did a great job with this. Capullo, the art was is definitely good with it, especially in these scenes where Batman's sanity comes, Batman's trying to grab a hold of his sanity as he tries to survive the Court of Owls labyrinth. And although it kind of makes it annoying trying to read it, I do like the positioning of the pages and panels to help with the how would I say it? The setting of this is Bruce's mind. He's pretty much on the brink of insanity in here. Yes, he's on the brink of insanity in here, so best to kind of reflect it with the positioning of the pages and panels. So leading into it, it's just the normal. Then it goes sideways and it goes upside down before going all the way back to normal. Unless this turned out to be a printing mistake by this book, then I don't know. But definitely 100%. It's great. Court of Owls is from the New 52. My favorite story, also my favorite Snyder story, not counting the current Justice League stuff. It is definitely a good Batman story. I would definitely recommend it. And like I said, there is, while the New 52 was, not popular, there were stuff that was good. It did have good series. It's just the whole, doesn't, just those small series, the small good ones can't sustain the whole thing. So stuff like Batman, Green Lanterns, Aquaman, all that, they were definitely the best from the New 52. Snyder's run later on kind of a bit of a mix, like especially when Jim Gordon took over as Batman. It's just like, it's nice that it's Jim Gordon, but he's like, given his age, and he's still like, even though he's supposed to be like a retired, having worked in the, I think it was the military, the army, he's retired. He's supposed to be, I don't know, over 50s roughly, I believe. But in then when he decide when they get him to be Batman, he's like, he looks incredibly young for someone of his age, and incredibly fit and agile for someone of his age. So it was a bit of a mix. It wasn't necessarily bad, but it's just like, this doesn't make sense in its entirety. But start of the New 52, Batman: The Court of Owls, definitely is a good was a good start was is a good start to Snyder's Batman run. Like I said, it was an interesting setup to a story. Great mystery, suspense. What did I say? No, not particularly. I was gonna say horror. I wouldn't say horror, but just dark is. Almost dark story. The art worked great and well with it, helped set up the atmosphere of the story. And that's definitely, that's when you would definitely have great art, is when it works so well with what the writer has in the story, what the writer is presenting in the story, essentially. But that's it for this video. Leave a like, subscribe, hit the notification bell if you haven't already, or if YouTube has messed with you. Leave a comment, check out my previous videos, check out my Twitter, and I will see you all next time.